Hey guys, my name is Nicolette Mashile. I am also known as The Financial Bunny. Welcome to The Financial Bunny TV. Today I want to talk all things paying off your debt using the 22/7 app. And no, don't get me wrong, there's nothing magical on the 22/7 app that is going to make your debt disappear all the time. It's all about working in partnership with the app, its expertise and its intelligence to be able to pay off your debt. Now it's very, very important for me to mention that nothing that I say on this video constitutes as financial advice. If you are looking for financial advice, please speak to somebody that is certified and registered with the FSCA. The first step you've got to do is to make sure that you have an actual goal to pay off your debt. Now, when you have a financial goal to pay off debt, it's important to know how much it is that you actually owe, what is the interest rate that you are being charged, and how much you are paying monthly as the minimum repayment amount, and what is the loan period. So you need to know how long is this loan for you to be able to calculate how much additionally you need to be able to pay into that specific debt to be able to pay it back. Now, I said something that is quite magic. The most important thing about paying off debt, especially before the allocated loan period or debt contract time, is paying additional amounts of money into that loan. Now, why is this beneficial? Not only will you finish paying that debt as quickly as possible, but also you end up paying less in interest over the long run. But where do you find this additional amount of money? Especially if you're already hitting a ceiling with your income or your salary. Well, that's when the 22/7 app comes into play and assists you. One of the most important things that I love saying is that your additional income stream already exists and it's in your spending habits. How are you spending your money? And that's what the 22/7 app gets to track. It shows you exactly what you are doing with your money on every single month. So it tracks all of your spending. Remember, one of the things that it does is that once you have allocated your budget categories, it will then allocate all of that spending to the different budget color categories that you've got. So it will tell you how much you're spending on retail. It will tell you how much money you're spending on takeaways. It will tell you how much money you are spending on debit orders. It will tell you how much money you're spending on data and airtime. It will even tell you how much money you are spending on fees, transactional fees, bank fees. Sometimes it even gives you a nudge of what is the average amount of money perhaps that people are paying in terms of insurance who are kind of in the same type of bracket that you are in, right? So all of those things are quite important because it starts to show you where you are spending your money. One of the things that we always say within this financial or personal finance fraternity is where you're spending your money is essentially where you are investing it. Now, if you want to invest in paying off your debt, it is important to make sure that you are tracking your spending and where you are seeing that, I may be going overboard. A lot of people are going overboard in data and airtime. A lot of people are going overboard in terms of their takeaways. Then you can start reallocating that money to paying additionally into these different types of debts that you want to pay off. And for the sake of this video, I want to focus on two types of strategies to be able to pay off your debt. One is called the avalanche method, the other one is called the snowball. So remember, going back a couple of steps, you now have your financial goals, you have downloaded the 22/7 app and you are using it, you've linked your bank account. Remember, it's safe, so you don't have to worry about somebody transacting on your account through the 22/7 app interface. They cannot, because it is a safe app where information is encrypted, right? But also remember, there's an extra layer of you receiving an OTP, or you need to approve your transactions on the actual app for anybody to be able to transact. So all that the app ever does on your account, that's why you may get that SMS every single day to say the 22/7 app has logged in into your bank account, is to oversee what's actually happening. What is your spending behavior? What is your transactional behavior that you are doing on that specific account, right? So one, you have a financial goal to pay off your debt. Two, you've downloaded the app, you've linked your bank accounts, you've done your budget allocations, and now you are letting the app do what it does best, and that is to show you and track your actual spending and be able to tell you also what your net worth is. Remember, the most important thing is to move your net worth from the negative amount of money that it may currently be sitting on to a zero, and from a zero to a positive balance now, where your assets outweigh your actual liabilities. And the third thing is to use one of the strategies that when you now can see through the app that you actually can reallocate some money because you are overspending on data, on takeaways, or on bank fees, then that money can now get reallocated to a date to pay additional. Then now you've got to choose which date you're going to start off with. And that's why I mentioned the snowball effect, or you can use the avalanche method. The snowball, you are going to start off with the smallest outstanding debt that you've got, and you're going to try and pay off that one as quickly as possible by paying additional amounts of money. Whereas if you use the avalanche method, on the other hand, you're going to pay the most expensive debt. And when we talk about the most expensive debt, we're talking about the debt that has the highest interest rate, because the debt that has the highest interest rate generally is the one that takes a big chunk of money out of your bank account every single month. So the quicker we pay that off, the bigger actually the amount that we will have to be able to reallocate to the next type of debt. I want you to think of a practical example, like your banking fees. How do you actually, if let's say for instance, maybe you are not misspending or spending too much, however, there may be a better way to do this. Bank fees is one of those where you might want to downgrade maybe from a specific color card to a much lower or perceived as a lower colored card so that your banking fees are not as high. Or alternatively, you could look at getting a bundle. You know, transaction fees sometimes are very high in if you're being charged individually for each and every single transaction. So you could potentially look at getting a bundle where you're getting maybe 5 bank transactions, 5 deposits, 5 internet transfers and all of that stuff, where it might be cheaper for you to be able to do that. Also, as I said, the app sometimes can tell you the average insurance that is being paid by people similar to you in terms of behavior, car, and all sorts of other things that obviously go into working out how much your insurance premium is. And you may try your luck and actually go and shop around for a cheaper insurance. And the app is able to give you this kind of intel. For me, it's like having the CIA on your bankroll, and basically, you know, they tell you all of these little financial secrets, and then you can use them to the betterment of your finances. That's basically how I see the 22/7 app. I know it sounds crazy, but that's really how I see it. So if you have not yet, please give the 22/7 app a chance. Download it, install it on your, download from the iOS shop or the Android store. Download on your phone, install it. Link your bank accounts. Remember, again, it is safe, and let's see the magic happen. Of course, you also have to actively participate by making sure that you are creating your budget categories and you're allocating certain amounts of money, but also you're honest with yourself. Remember, it's an app. It's between you and a cell phone or where the platform that you're using the app on. And nobody else gets to see this. You know, the guys at 22/7 app don't get to see everything that you're doing. The app just reads what your behavior is on the app. So this is between, if you want to better your finances, this could be the best way to start.